Hi, in this video, we want to talk about a measure called F sub beta for evaluating the classification problems. And in this video, we are going to study an example, both by hand and also by Python programming language with sklearn package. So suppose this confusion matrix, which is an example, which we are going to consider and study in this video. So let's start from the beginning. For example, this 6 means there are 6 cases which the actual label is positive, and also we have predicted positive. So in Python, for example, we have the defined variable, let's say called yTrue, which means the true labels. So there are 6 cases, as you can see, there are 6 cases which the actual label is positive. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cases which the actual label is positive. And the predicted label is also positive. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 cases which the actual label is positive and also the predicted label is positive. And this 2 means there are 2 cases which the actual label is negative. So 2 cases which the actual label is negative and the predicted label is positive. So there it is. And also there is 1 case which the actual label is negative. And the predicted label is also negative. And also there is 1 case which the actual label is positive. So the actual label is positive, but the predicted label is negative. So these are 2 variables, yTrue and yPred, the true labels and the predicted labels. And in this table, this 6 is called TP. It stands for truly positive. It means that we have truly predicted positive. It was positive and we have truly predicted positive. So it is TP. And this guy is false positive because we have falsely predicted positive. It was negative actually, but we have falsely predicted positive. And this guy is true negative because we have truly predicted negative. It was negative actually, and we have predicted negative. So we have truly predicted negative. And this guy is false negative because we have falsely predicted as negative. It was actually positive, but we have falsely predicted as negative. So it is called false negative. And let's go further. As you can see, we have predicted 8 cases as positive. So we have predicted 8 cases as positive. Let's call them, for example, p hat. It means that we have predicted positive 8 cases which we have predicted positive. And also you can see that there were 2 cases which we have predicted as negative. So there are 2 cases which we have predicted as negative. So let's call them n hat. N hat means we are predicting negative. So n hat is equal to 2 and p hat is equal to 8. But here there are 3 cases which are actually negative. So n is equal to 3. So there are 3 negative cases in total, and also there are 7 cases in total which are truly positive. And finally, the total cases are 10. But in order to calculate F sub beta, we need to calculate precision and recall. But what does precision mean? Precision means among all the cases which we have predicted positive, among 8 cases which we have predicted positive, how many of them was correct? So you can see that 6 out of 8 of them was correct. So the precision formula is how many cases among all the cases which we have predicted as positive was correctly predicted as positive. Correctly predicted as positive means true positive. So the formula is true positive divided by p hat, which in this example is 6 divided by 8, which is 3 divided by 4. But now let's talk about recall. Recall means among all the cases which was actually positive, how many cases have we predicted correctly? So as I said, it means among all the cases which were actually positive, how many cases did we predict truly positive? So this is TP divided by P. And you can see that it is equal to 6 divided by 7. So the recall is 6 divided by 7. So the formula of F sub beta is this, and let's plug in these values to this formula. So the precision is 3 divided by 4. The precision is 3 divided by 4. And the recall is 6 divided by 7. And for example, suppose that we want to calculate f sub 2. And now if we plug in beta, we can see the result is 1 plus 2 to the power of 2, which is 4. So 1 plus 4, which is 5 times these guys. And 2 to the power of 2, which is 4 times 3 divided by 4. 3 divided by 4 plus 6 divided by 7. And remember that this multiplication is only for the precision, not for the recall. So if you do the calculations, the results will be 0.8333333 and etc. But now let's calculate it in Python programming language with sklearn package. So we simply type from sklearn.metrics, import fbeta score, and we simply type fbeta score, and we should pass ytrue and ypred, and also the beta is, let's say for example, 2, because you want to calculate f sub 2. If you want to calculate f sub, for example, 0.5, then you will pass beta equals to 0.5. So I'm calculating f sub 2, so it is f sub 2, f2, let's say. And now let's print the values. So this is f2, which is equal to f2 variable, and if I run the code, you can see the result is the same as we have calculated by hand. It is 0.833333 and etc. But now let's talk about two final notes. The first note is if you plug in beta equals to 1, you will see that a formula is this, which is f score, or sometimes called f1 score. And now you understand why they call it f1 score, because it's a special kind of f sub beta. And note number two. There are two values for beta which are common and typical in reporting, and those are 0.5 and 2.